here's how to troubleshoot a no post issue on your PowerEdge server. No post describes a situation where the system powers on, but fails a check during power on self test or post. Depending on your system and issue, you may see a post error message on your monitor if present, or see that diagnostic LEDs are on or blinking. If this does not describe your issue, go to dell.com/support and refer to KB Article 152.161 for help with other startup issues like no power, no boot, and no video. If you have a specific post error displayed on a monitor, front panel display, or indicated by motherboard LEDs, search for support on that error. You'll find an explanation of the motherboard LED codes in the manual for your system. If you don't have a specific error, follow these steps to identify which component is causing the post failure. We'll be removing parts in groups and testing. If we find that removing a part allows the system to post, we can then troubleshoot that suspect part. First, power down the system and remove any external devices except for a monitor connected to the onboard video port. Remove both power cables, then hold down the power button for 10 seconds to drain any residual power. Reconnect the power cables, then wait 2 minutes for the iDRAC to initialise before attempting to power on. If this allows the system to post, re-add the peripherals one at a time to identify which one is causing the issue. If possible, two-way swap the suspect part with one you know is working correctly with another system. If the part is faulty, we'd expect to see the post issue move with it to the other system, and the original system to work correctly with the known good part. If you're still seeing the same issue, repeat the procedure, this time also removing any third-party components that have been added to the system. Remember to drain residual power and allow iDRAC time to initialise. If the fault persists, next try also disconnecting hard drives, then optical and internal tape drives, then PCI cards. If post still fails with all of these removed, reseat the control panel connector. Check your system manual for specific guidance on how to do this. Also refer to your manual for the system's minimum to post hardware requirements. Remove all other components from the system, leaving only those in the minimum to post list. When performing this test, please remember to disconnect components like the backplane and integrated NICs such as OCP or NDCs and anything else not explicitly mentioned in the list. As before, if disconnecting components allows the system to post, reconnect them one at a time to identify the suspect part. If your server has multiple instances of the same part, CPUs for example, but only requires one to post, try replacing the single part being used. If the system still fails post with CPU 1 in socket 1, try with CPU 2 in socket 1 instead. Depending on the minimum hardware to post required, you may be able to narrow the issue down to either the motherboard or a given component in this way, or you may be left with several possibilities, such as motherboard, CPU, or RAM. You can also swap known good parts from other systems for testing if these are available. Thanks for watching.